I think that the first half, especially the first 25 minutes, we came in very well. We created opportunities early, but after the last 15, 20 minutes of the first half, Edmonton was a little bit better, you know. They settled in the game. It was more equal. In the second half, we had a lot of problems in the beginning, especially the first 25 minutes. I felt that, you know, playing against the wind now, a lot of balls stopping in the air, it was tough to get out of pressure. But at the end of the day, after those 25 minutes, we started to grow a little bit more, you know, and it became an open game, a game that we created situations, they created situations. Our goalkeeper made a fantastic save at the end. It would be unfair for if Edmonton would have scored, but what I think is that with the guys that we have out and the depth that we have and the players that are answering and the character of the team, I'm very positive to what's to come. You know, the way this team has been built from the beginning, we think we're really in the right direction.
Pretty physical game throughout there, too. That's surprising.
We knew it, man. We knew it. This is four times 45 minutes, right? Now we're at halftime of a game. And we're talking at halftime. There's another 90 minute left. If you tell me what's the best score after the leg one, I would tell you I want to win 5-0, right? But the reality is, if you do tie, at least tie 0-0 home, knowing that the goal away counts for two. You know, last year the Impact played the final against Vancouver. They tied 0-0 home. And they tied 2-2 in Vancouver and won it. So the goal away is important, and we're going to score in Edmonton.
The makeshift back line, loss of Omar Giroux. What did you think of the back four you had there tonight?
I thought that Drew Becky answered very well. Drew Becky is a player that was drafted by Columbus for a reason, right? And it wasn't by fluke or luck. And he didn't get to play in Columbus, but he's young. He's a young defender still. He could get back in MLS if he continues like that. If we need him right back, he answers. Center back, he had an excellent game tonight again. And Frezenga also answered well. So it proves that we have a lot of guys that could play in this team if there's injuries. And I'm happy with the character. I felt that maybe we could have scored. But again, if we tie, 0-0 is the best tie possible.
Marc, c'est une semaine de première pour Ottawa. Premier match dans la NASL, premier match à la maison, premier match du championnat canadien. On a senti une équipe quand même très bien, très disciplinée au niveau défensif. Qu'est-ce qui manque pour justement marquer ce but qui aurait pu permettre au
Ouais,
FC de prendre les devants dans le
c'est une
championnat?
bonne question. On a besoin d'être des fois un peu plus chanceux. Des fois, on sent que on est presque là, mais il manque un maître. Il manque Mason dans la deuxième demi, a une excellente chance de marquer dans une situation de ballon arrêté. Mike Conn, dehors de la surface, il a frappé mal sur le ballon. Mais moi, je pense que si on ne crée pas des opportunités, je serais plus inquiet. Mais dans les trois matchs qu'on a fait, on a quand même créé des opportunités. Il faut continuer, il faut continuer. On a Edmonton a 140 matchs dans leur histoire, puis nous, on en a trois. Donc, la cohésion, les gars se connaissent un peu plus. On sent que de plus en plus, ils savent un peu plus un sur les autres, mais c'est trois matchs dans notre histoire. Puis, le positif, c'est qu'on joue à Fort Lauderdale, un match qu'on a eu 65% de possession de ballon, on a créé, puis on a perdu. On joue contre Minnesota, on perd contre une des meilleures équipes de la Ligue dans la dernière seconde du match, 2-1. On joue contre Edmonton, c'est 0-0. Donc, on a créé quelque chose ici, on a bâti quelque chose qu'aujourd'hui, on compétitionne contre tout le monde. Maintenant, il faut commencer à les battre. Puis on pense que ça, c'est possible
Est-ce que
aussi.
c'est le début d'une rivalité entre le FC Edmonton et le Fury FC, à voir aussi le tempérament des joueurs là, durant le match, les quelques escarmouches qu'il y a eu?
Ouais, ça va être une guerre là-bas. On va pas être bien reçu là-bas, c'est sûr. On s'en attend.
Merci, Marc.
Philip Davies, night and day game when you compare today to the game against Minnesota. What were the keys for him? And he was creating a lot more on the wing. Speak a little bit about that.
Night and day.
Yeah. Very different.
Yeah, but not like water and wine.
No.
No?
What's water and wine?
No, water and wine. You know why? Because I think that Phil, okay, just see this. Phil didn't play in Fort Lauderdale, and he gets a game against Minnesota where he's quite active but doesn't create a lot, right? Phil is such an intelligent player, a gifted player, good technically. It's a player that played in the U-17 of Canada, U-20 of Canada, Olympic team of Canada, always playing, and he needs to play. You know, to get rhythm, he needs to play. That's why it was a better game. And hopefully every day, Phil's just going to get better. A player needs rhythm, right? And again, I repeat, this is our third game.